The Philippine government and the San Miguel-led consortium SMC SAP and Company signed the 170.6 billion peso Ninoy-Aquino International Airport rehabilitation contract. Let's get details from our correspondent, Pia Gutierrez. Pia, hi, go ahead.
Hi, Michelle. Yes, we just finished today in Malacañang the signing of the landmark concession agreement for the Ninoy-Aquino International Airport public-private partnership project between the Department of Transportation, the Manila International Airport Authority, and the winning bidder, SMC SAP and Company Consortium. DOTR Secretary Jaime Bautista, MIA General Manager Eric Ines, and San Miguel CEO Ramon Ang signed the concession agreement witnessed by no less than President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. The deal aims to modernize, expand, and rehabilitate the country's main gateway. It is also seen to address long-standing issues plaguing the NAIA airport, such as flight delays and poor passenger experience, by increasing the capacity of the airport from 35 million passengers per year to 62 million per year, increasing the air traffic movement per hour from 40 to 48, mobilizing resources and expertise from the private sector for the modernization and capacity expansion, and providing improved passenger experience and retail options. In his speech, President Marcos Jr. welcomed the signing of the agreement, noting that the rehabilitation of the airport is already long delayed. He also urged the consortium, now called the New NAIA Infracorp, to fulfill its commitments to the PPP project, saying that the project is an investment in the country's future, contributing much to the economic growth for the country while expecting to lift tourism arrivals with improved levels of services and upgraded airport infrastructure. The president also called on the consortium to go beyond the improvements at the airport, but also to address traffic congestion at the roads leading to the airport. And in his speech before the signing, San Miguel Corporation President and CEO Ramon Ang said that the PPP deal will generate an expected 900 billion pesos in revenues for the national government in the course of its entire concession period, which is 15 years with a provision for extension of another 10 years. Let's listen to Ramon.
This landmark PPP project is the largest of its kind in the country. It's expected to generate over 900 billion pesos in revenue for the government, nearly nine times the financial benefit of the previous unsolicited proposal. Its impact goes beyond financial gains, promising to boost the economy and improve the lives of countless Filipinos. Our vision for NAIA extends beyond mere rehabilitation. We aim to significantly enhance its functionality and establish a new standard in service excellence. Current users will enjoy enhanced experience even as we lay the groundwork for the future. Within 6 months from September 2024, we aim to elevate your airport experience through streamlined process, faster check-ins, and upgraded amenities. Ultimate goal is to provide an exceptional travel experience for every passenger at every touch point.
The project, Michelle, is hailed as the fastest approved PPP proposal in Philippine history at 7 weeks. But in his speech, the president assured that the deal was fastidiously examined and that the processes leading to its approval were all open and transparent. Meanwhile, Finance Secretary Ralph Recto and NEDA Secretary Estenio Balisacan also hailed the project as a sign that the government is really committed towards connectivity and inclusive growth. Let's listen to their speeches.
The NAIA PPP deal is a crowning achievement of the Marcos Jr. administration. It carries with it unprecedented feats achieved through strong partnership between the government and the private sector, guided by a president with a clear determination to uplift the lives of Filipinos. The NAIA PPP project sets the benchmark for efficiency for the government's pipeline projects, being the fastest approved PPP proposal in Philippine history. This underscores the Marcos Jr. administration's strong commitment to act fast on investments so that our people can benefit from them at the soonest possible time.
This project underscores the government's dedication to ongoing infrastructure development aimed at enhancing connectivity and inclusivity. By catalyzing economic activities, the modernization of NAIA will have far-reaching positive effects across various sectors. It's expected to boost tourism, improve mobility, facilitate trade, strengthen our global economic ties, bridge regional disparities, stimulate investment and construction, and foster growth in the services sector, ultimately leading to significant job creation.
With the signing of the concession agreement, the operations and maintenance of the airport will be handed over to the new NAIA InfraCorp on or before September 2024. And in an interview following the program, Ramon Ang assures the public to expect to see significant improvements in the airport in as early as 6 months after the turnover, or by around Holy Week next year, with streamlined processes, faster check-in procedures, and the upgraded amenities at the airport. Michelle.
Thank you very much for that update. Pia Gutierrez joining us on the line from Malacañang. Of course, just a bit of context there. Mr. Ramon Ang, the SMC SAP Consortium, actually beat two other competitors for this project, including the Super Consortium. They had offered a revenue share with government of 82.16%. That is more than double what was offered by its two competitors. They're also expected, according to some reports, to make the 30 billion peso upfront payment to the government after the signing. The consortium is, of course, made up of San Miguel, the Korean airport operator Incheon International Airport, as well as local companies RLW Aviation Development and RWM Asian Logistics, Inc. This is going to be another airport project for Mr. Ramon Ang. This is a 170 billion peso project to rehabilitate NAIA, the main gateway of the country. But he also bagged the other airport project a couple of years ago. That is the 730 billion peso, a much bigger project for the Bulacan Airport project. The strong El Nino phenomenon continues to wreak havoc on Philippine farmlands. The Agriculture Department estimates the damage has climbed to 1.31 billion pesos as of mid-March. Areas primarily affected include Western Visayas, Zamboanga, and Ilocos, or those on the western side of the archipelago. The DA, however, assures the public this amount is still smaller compared to the damage incurred after the El Nino hit the country in the late 90s. Five towns in Oriental and Occidental Mindoro already declared a state of calamity. Authorities earlier warned as many as 70 provinces will experience El Nino until April, with La Nina expected to begin by July.
Hindi pa po tapos yung peak ng El Nino, although sabi nga ng pag-asa nag-weekend na ito. Ang binabantayan talaga natin ngayon, obviously, is yung plight o yung sitwasyon ng mga magsasaka sa mga probinsya. Bagamat tinutulungan na po ng gobyerno ang mga magsasakang ito. Pero ang binabantayan, particularly din dito sa Metro Manila, is yung obviously yung water supply. Kasi hindi naman natin maitatatwa na kapag umiinit po, mas tumataas po ang konsumo sa mga household. At saka po pati yung nag-evaporate po yung ating sources of water. But having said that, in particular sa Metro Manila po, meron po mga contingency measures.
We are getting a mixed bag of fuel price adjustments this week. Pilipinas Shell has just announced gasoline is going down by 10 centavos per liter. Is it going down or is it going up? Let's see. It's going up. Let me correct that. Gasoline prices are going up by 10 centavos per liter. Diesel is going to be down by the same amount. It is going down, yes. It's a mixed bag. Well, kerosene will see no change. The adjustment is effective 6 a.m. tomorrow, Tuesday. More than 2 million passengers expected to flock to seaports across the country in time for the Holy Week. That figure is higher than last year's nearly 1.9 million who traveled by sea during the Lenten season. The ports with an expected surge in passenger volumes include those in Panay, Guimaras, Batangas, and Mindoro, Calapan. With the anticipated exodus, the Philippine Ports Authority says it is preparing measures to ensure passenger convenience. All students, persons with disabilities, senior citizens, and men in uniform are also exempted from paying terminal fees. Now, a Philippine House lawmaker asserts Manila's ongoing maritime disputes with Beijing should not affect the country's tourism. House Committee on Tourism Vice Chairperson Marvin Rilio made that remark after the Tourism Department reported the number of Chinese tourists who visited the Philippines in the first 2 months of this year more than tripled to over 82,000 from just 24,500 year-on-year. China leapfrogged five other countries, including Canada, Australia, and Japan, that supplied the country with the largest number of visitors during the same period a year ago. Relia believes China is set to reclaim its spot as the second biggest supplier of foreign visitors to the Philippines after South Korea. Now, remember, for context, before COVID-19 pandemic in 2019, more than 1.7 Chinese million Chinese tourists visited the Philippines, second only to South Korea's nearly 2 million tourists.